Now that I've created the necessary Oracle Cloud infrastructure resources and created an Oracle Database Cloud Service deployment, I can provision an Oracle Java Cloud Service instance. As with my database instance, before provisioning the Java Cloud Service instance, I'll need to have the following information available: the availability domain, the subnet name, which must be in the same virtual cloud network as the subnet that I selected earlier for the database cloud service, the object storage bucket name, the Swift password, and the region I created with my Oracle Cloud Infrastructure resources. Using my service credentials, I'll log into the My Services dashboard. From the Action menu for my Java Cloud Service account, I'll select Open Service Console, and on the Service Console, click Create Service, and from the drop-down control, select Java. First, on the Basic Service Information page, I'll give my Java Cloud Service a name and select the region from the drop-down list. This should be the same region that I created the Oracle Cloud Infrastructure Resources and Database Cloud Service deployment in. As with the Database Service instance, selecting the region spawns the Availability domain and the Subnet fields. I'll select values for these fields based on the information I recorded while creating the infrastructure resources. Since I want to use the default values for the rest of the subscription details, I'll click Next and move on to the Wizard Service Details page. Here, I'll enter critical information about my service. First, I'll select a compute shape that will meet my load and processing requirements. Note that I can only select an Oracle Cloud Infrastructure compute shape. Next, I'll insert an SSH public key, which provides authentication when connecting to a node in my instance through a secure shell client. I'll click Edit to open the Public Access Key for VM dialog box, and here, select Choose File to open my file system. I'll select the public key, and then click Enter. And the public key has been inserted. Now, I'll select Enable Access to Administration Consoles so that I can access consoles such as WebLogic Server or Fusion Middleware from within the service instance. Next, I'll create and confirm an administration password, which I can use when I need to access these administration consoles. Now, I'll select the database instance I created in the earlier exercise and enter the appropriate username and password. For the backup destination, I'll first select both remote and disk storage, which will spawn these three new data fields: cloud storage container, username, and password. For my cloud storage container, I'll enter the URL for the object storage bucket I created as one of my infrastructure resources. This can be a rather long entry since I need to enter the full URL in this fixed format. The variables in that format are region, tenant, and bucket. This is why I made sure to copy the name after I created the bucket. Now, I'll enter the username and Swift password I generated earlier, then accept the remaining defaults and click Next. I'll verify the details of my service, paying particular attention to the compute shape, region, availability domain, subnet, and the storage configuration. Those all look fine, so I'll click Create. In a moment, my new service will appear on the Java Cloud Service console. I can track provisioning progress here in the Service Create and Delete History panel, simply by clicking Details. And I can see that my service instance has been successfully provisioned. Next, I want to connect over a secure shell to the Java Cloud Service node on Oracle Cloud Infrastructure. I'll go to the Service Details page for my new Java Cloud Service instance and copy the public IP address. Then, I'll open a command shell and, using the public IP address, make the connection. Now that I'm connected, I'll check the host name of the node to verify that it matches the name of the VCN I set up in the first exercise. I can see that it does. I have now successfully provisioned a Java Cloud Service instance in Oracle Cloud Infrastructure and connected to it over a secure shell. I'm ready to start deploying and managing applications in the cloud. Thank you for watching Creating a Java Cloud Service Instance on Oracle Cloud Infrastructure. For more information, please visit us online.